Last time we saw vertical angles, corresponding angles, and alternate interior angles. In this video, I would like to connect them with the corner cube reflection. But I need to point out one more thing before proving the corner cube reflection. That is a mirror reflection, how light reflects from a mirror surface. Here is the surface of a mirror. I will draw a line perpendicular to the mirror. This line shows the direction of the mirror surface. It has a name called the normal vector, or simply the normal. The name is useful, but not so important. The important thing is you know what it is. Because the normal is perpendicular to the mirror surface, it means the measure of the angle between the mirror and the normal is 90 degrees. You might say, the direction of a mirror is simple, why it has a name? Yes, it is simple if the mirror is flat. If a mirror is curved, the idea of the normal becomes useful because it is different everywhere on the curve. This time though, we have only a flat mirror. The angle between the incident ray and the normal is called the angle of incident. I write this angle's measure as theta I. The angle between the outgoing reflected ray and the normal is called the angle of reflection. I write this angle's measure as theta R. Light reflecting from a perfect mirror is called specular reflection. In specular reflection, theta I is equal to theta R. There are other types of reflections, but in this video, we are only concerned with specular reflection. Here, I also want to point out the angle between the mirror surface and the incident ray. A fancy mathematical name for the mirror surface direction is a tangent direction. Tangent is also different everywhere on the curve. But we are dealing with a flat mirror, so we can also simply say the mirror's surface. There are also the angles between the ray direction and the tangent. Let's see the left-hand side first. The measure of the angle between the normal and surface is 90 degrees. Here is a theta I, then this is 90 minus theta I. Next, let's see the right-hand side. The measure of the angle between the normal and surface is again 90 degrees. Here is the theta r, then this is 90 minus theta r. Remember, theta I is equal to theta r, I call this theta null. Then what is the relationship between 90 minus theta I and 90 minus theta r? As you see, these angles have the same measure too. So I set these both angles' name as theta null dash. We now know many angles have the same measure. Finally, let's talk about the corner cube. The real corner cube has three mirrors, but for the sake of simplicity, I show the corner of these two mirrors. But the principle is the same as the three mirrors case. This corner has a 90 degrees angle. A ray is incoming to here. I draw the normal, where the ray reflects on the mirror. The normal and the mirror surface has 90 degrees angle. These two line segments, L1 and L2, are crossing the left mirror surface with the same measure, 90 degrees. I want to remind you that these right angles are corresponding angles. This means L1 and L2 are parallel. Now, a ray is incoming to the left mirror. There is a specular reflection here. Then the measure of the angle of incident and the angle of reflection are the same. Thus, if I put the measure of this angle is theta, then the measure of this angle is also theta. The reflection ray goes to the upper mirror and again make a specular reflection. Let's say the measure of this angle is x. I just pointed out a few seconds ago that the line segments L1 and L2 are parallel. Let's put the transversal line M of L1 and L2. We already know that alternative interior angles have the same measure, thus x is equal to theta. Let's put back the mirrors and the normal. At the upper reflection point, the ray makes a specular reflection, then we know this angle y is equal to theta again. We now know a lot of thetas. Let's extend the third ray a bit to see the vertical angle of this. The vertical angle of this is also equal to theta. put back the second ray. The measure of this angle is theta plus theta. The figure is a bit busy, so I will remove the upper mirror. This is 2 theta. The measure of this angle around the first reflection point is also equal to 2 theta. Let's extend a bit of the first ray and the second ray. Let's say these two line segments as O1 and O2. I will refer to this line as line M. Now these two thetas are alternate interior angles. Then the line M is a transversal line to O1 and O2. And the alternate interior angles have the same measure, 2 theta here. This means O1 and O2 are parallel. Finally, I show that these lines are parallel, which means the incident ray of this corner cube will be reflected in the exact opposite of its original direction. This is a proof of why laser light reflected by a corner cube is always reflected back in the direction from which it came. It's nice, isn't it? I hope you enjoy this video. See you next time!